Could you imagine crowding 19 people in this boat without a sail and going for 80 or 90 miles?
The Dry Tortugas National Park just off the coast of Key West is closed again tonight after more than 300 Cuban migrants landed on the island. Law enforcement needs to evaluate and coordinate transportation for those who've landed over the last few days. Meantime, the crew of a cruise ship rescued at least one boat loaded with more than a dozen Cubans fleeing their homeland.
NBC2's Dave Elias talks with a local woman who witnessed the rescue from that cruise ship.
Well, this boat is about 8 feet long, and it's called the Optimist, and maybe for good reason if you were going to crowd 19 people into this boat. Cuban migrants are doing just that, and they're headed for the United States. Today, one Fort Myers woman caught their rescue on camera.
They had paddles, and they were, 19 people, and they were hanging over the sides of the boat. The boat was falling apart. The seas were super rough.
Maria Paterno is describing this dramatic video that she shot, which shows migrants at sea being rescued by a celebrity cruise boat.
They were so happy to see us. They were, waving their T-shirts and screaming for help.
The group had been at sea for 3 days after leaving Cuba in this pile of garbage turned into a boat.
It was siding of a home. It was like home siding, styrofoam, duct tape, ropes. It was a desperate situation, for sure.
Ryan Tursky has been sailing for years and called the migrants lucky.
The waves, if the waves get bad, it could flip your boat. Without life jackets, it wouldn't be long before they'd get fatigued out and drown, unfortunately.
300 Cuban migrants have braved that trip. Their boats lined up here on the shores of Dry Tortugas Park. Sutton Bohannon and Madison Smith were in similar-sized boats today on the rough waters of the Caloosahatchee and can't imagine a 90-mile trip.
Today we had gusts of up to 20, and it was blowing 12 knots, I'd say. So to be in more than that in a small boat with so many people, I don't know how
they made it, really.
Even these four young sailors in training realize the dangers.
That would be miserable, to be honest.
Misery that doesn't show any signs of stopping.
Now, if you were planning on making a trip to Dry Tortuga Park, the U.S. Coast Guard predicts that it's going to be closed for several days. We're local in Lee County, Dave Elias, NBC2.